Howdy, y'all. Welcome to the Beverly Hillbillies Facts and Trivia. Y'all kick off the shoes and you set a spell, all right? Now here's your host for the show, the old Kentucky boy himself, Mr. Bob Snapp.
Hi guys, welcome to the Beverly Hillbillies Facts and Trivia. Thank you so much for being here. Today's video is on how Hollywood stars were lining up to be a part of Beverly Hillbillies. Such a success, everybody wanted to be a part of it, and some that weren't exactly lining up. Some actors like Raymond Massey were so anxious for a guest spot on the Beverly Hillbillies or even a cameo appearance that they sent kind notes to Paul Henning with more than subtle hints that they'd love to work for him. When the show hit hard, Spike Jonze enthusiastically offered his talents as musical director. Back then, it was like today's version of supplying a guest voice on The Simpsons. An episode of Hillbillies was the thing to do. There were some, like Glenn Campbell, whom Paul Henning pursued. Henning and another writer prepared a full script on spec, hoping the young singer might appear on the show. His manager, Nick Savino, never delivered Paul Henning's persistent solicitations because he thought the show was beneath his client. The script was quickly rewritten and Pat Boone was substituted. Another script idea had the Hillbillies sing an old Shirley Temple film, Captain January, in which Buddy Ebsen danced with her. Of course, the Hillbillies, charmed by her cuteness, would still think of her as the six-year-old Moppet. The former actress was approached about appearing on the show, but declined, and the idea was dropped. Those were just some of the more interesting, and I wanted to say a few things about some, like Spike Jonze would have never worked with Beverly Hillbillies for one thing, but Glenn Campbell. I think he would have done it. He seemed like he was always up for something like that. And I think his manager was a snob. And I'm sorry, that's the way I see it. But to replace him with Pat Boone. Pat Boone's a nice guy, great for what he does. He's not a country singer, man. There were all them country stars out there. They could have got a hold up to do it. That would have been, it would have been easy. It would have been another Roy Clark guest appearance. I mean, Roy Clark was one of the funniest things I ever seen on TV when he appeared on there. It's just a shame they didn't do that. I mean, there were more. There was, of course, Sharon Tate and Don Rickles and I can't think of any. Jeff White. What is his name? I can't remember. But he was the one that was suing the Clampets. He also was on the Andy Griffith Show. I remember him being on there. But anyway. It was a place to be, man. I mean, everybody, once something takes off, they want to grab a hold and be a part of it, you know. Kind of like The Simpsons did, exactly. That's all I got for you guys. Hope you enjoyed this. Please don't forget about classic TV facts and trivia. It's on Gunsmoke. And the reason Matt Dillon and Miss Kitty never kissed. Then you got classic rock and country music facts and trivia, and I'm gone country this time. The bond between Waylon Jennings, Buddy Holly, and Buddy's motorcycle. Y'all take a look at those for me, and please like this video. Please subscribe if you have not yet. You guys have a great day. God bless, and I'm praying for you.